I don't know whether you all can hear me. Everyone, if you have, please open the chat window and I think press throughout the session, right?
Yes.
Okay. Manage the chat if there are any concerns about audio or anything.
My 2 o'clock also in another class, sir.
Okay. 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 So let me start the session. I saw a lot of hands going up. Unfortunately, it will be difficult for me to each of you speak now. SARC Oral Coaching for the December 2020 session of the CMA exams. And we have to be or the lectures going on open management and strategic management in two. I'm Srivatsan. I've been a faculty since 2002 for SA and Institutes, often only with the Institute of Cost Accountants of India. The session now. You understand there are about, I don't know, any participants as of now, Prashant, any idea? About 86 participants, and it will be impossible to give talk to anyone. There are the lecture will be only in English. I'll not be able to use vernacular language given the diversity of the student population. Start with the operations management topic. As you know, it's two parts: operations management and strategic management. It's going to be for 50 marks, and strategic management is going to be for 30 marks. It'll be by me and another professor, Mr. Suresh. So while the topics along with him. This 70 marks, about 40 to 50 would be problems. The rest would be theory. So it's very important. You may get up to 30 marks in theory in operations management. That's for sure in study management theory. So just with theory, you can go up to marks. And there are many simple problems, 2 mark, 3 mark problems, which you can easily reproduce in the exams. Preparing these problems. All problems in operations management are easy. Even with that, there are some very, very simple problems. Once you know all these problems in the theory part, it's a very easy subject to score. The highest I've scored in the past is a 93 in this paper within the few sessions, 2 or 3 sessions. So that explains that is a scoring subject. And many students report a 70 plus mark in this paper. So 70 or 80 in a paper, it releases a lot of pressure on the rest of the subjects. Have IDT and then cost management, accounting, and so on and so forth. So you can choose this as one of your scoring subjects, your aggregate, as well as for getting rank. If you're aspiring to get a rank, you can use this subject to score the best possible mark here. So, the subject. chapters in operations management. We'll start with operations management. We'll come to strategic management later on. And chapters 1, 3, and things are mostly theory.
Yeah.
Hello. Hello. If someone wants. Okay. So 5 are theory, and chapter 2, 4, 6, and 7 have theory as well as process. So said there are more problems you will need less than 10 minutes to solve. So the topics where you may need more than 10 minutes are your transportation, agent, network dumps. Oh my God, somebody is continuously or can you take whoever wants to speak? So there are more procedural questions here. So the subject, especially operations management and strategic management, is going to be more static, unlike your directors or accounting where laws keep changing, or even cost accounting where costing or cost accounting standards are introduced. Here you don't have all those challenges. So you are writing in December or the upcoming June 21, you will not go waste here, or at least it never goes. But for other subjects, you may have to update yourselves. Here there is no much updation happening. Or just on the topic and ensure that you are in touch with the topic until June for you scoring. And will there be another session similar to this for June? We don't know. See, given the COVID-19 situation, we don't know when this is going to end, when we'll all be roaming free as normal human beings after 6-7 months back. So use of the opportunity, sitting at home, spend 2 hours a day if you are able to study all these subjects of the support of the institute, then I would say you should not miss it. Roam around even in the situation outside, so better to stay at home and use your time. So as a matter, if you talk which would problem topics which would require more than 10 minutes to solve, which are and then the work, CPI. If it's a simple diagram, you can quickly solve it. So, and there is one topic in maintenance, replacement. In all these cases, you may need more than 10 minutes to solve. So, drive here is all topics are pretty simple, straightforward. Are comfortable doing few examples, you'll be able to take the problems head on in the exams. So I wanted to communicate. Now it's a live program where we are talking to each other in a classroom, face to face, and then let for 2 minutes to try to do this in yourselves. So what operations management? Here is the subject. Excuse me. Operations management. See, one thing, subject, even spend time to make assumptions about the subject. So you can understand the subject with your fundamental knowledge, what you have. So once you do that, learn a lot more easier. So with your understanding, and then compare it with facts, what you that meaning much more. So when you take in your assumptions, then your brain remembers it far better than straight from the book. So what operations management? On mute, I hear some background noise. Prashant? Coming back, since management managing your operations. In this case, what a study is business operations, but in any operations, when you are managing it, it becomes operation management. So, definition. So, one is managing something. Managing is ensuring that you're planning, performing, controlling, so forth, which you study in your normal management subject, part of the syllabus. But operations, you need to know what is operations, what is business operations. So, moving on. So, since then, operating system is resources coming together to products or services. So, a operating system or business operations. There are factory, machine, material, so on and so forth, all come together to a service. So, operating system is coming together to provide some goods or service. And going to manage that system, so that operations management. So operating system. All these come together. It's called our skeletal system. Operating system, skeletal system. The system. All these bones come together, and the object to give you shape and able to give you ability and so on. So forth. So, what is this? It's a comp system. We call it a computer system. We just call it system. It is on the system, switch of the system, so on and so forth. Various components here. Your monitor, GPU, board, all these come together to render service of computing. There you compute. As a transport system. Again, simple terms which we have been learning for a long time. Transport system. These the bus stops, bus stands, road, everything coming together. This to move people from transport here to move people from one point to another. Not a country. This transport system we are seeing here. So, different similarly, when various processes of a business come together, called business operations, it's business and you're going to measure that. Now, again, I'll give you 2 minutes. Think of all of business operations. When you're talking about operations looks problem with a shared screen. Probably share again. Can you my screen? So I add my screen. Something. Thank you. Whoever it was. So different systems. Operations, business operations. Requirement or human resource department. All the business operations, the core operations. For which is created. Once not all form part, processes form part of that business operation. Area form part of business options. Is it 1 minute for you to think through it? I'll include, say, what you study in costing, in stock. Stock mass part of operations. If you topics in operations management, you go to the contents, table contents in the book. All different tools. These are the tools used to for business, say transportation, assignment, simulation, queuing theory. Four of these are different research tools to manage your business operations. What we would be doing is, say, when you are managing your business, you are supposed to optimize your results. So we need to optimize our results. So complex operations, it could be transporting your raw material, transporting your finished goods, work among employees, managing the project, process project, improving a new product, improving an existing product, design all marketing process or service delivery process. Say things are not very prominent few months back. Now they're very prominent. They are a service option. What do they request, collect from anywhere and deliver it anywhere else. Like a quick service, but very fast. And they deliver anything. Want to say box bar from Subway hotel, you can just ask them to go collect it. They let them come in with you. You pay separately, and the delivery sometimes are free, sometimes are charged. So it's a business operation. So design the process. So part of your business operation. This is one topic, right? Your third chapter is about product and process design. And then casting, what is going to be your sales? Because based on that, you need to plan your purchase. You need to know you're going to purchase, what raw material, how many people do you need for planning your overall production process, how many units you are going to produce daily, how many machinery do you need then to set up your office, the right to set your factory, to design your factory. optics are part of cooperation. Say funding all this is finance. And for all the transactions and events is your finance department, accounts and finance department. Buttons is run the business and all components of the business. Interaction with all these other departments like finance, HR, and so on, IT, technology department. And however, for operations, these are going to be components of your core operations. So operations. What are components of business operations? So he's raised a hand. Prashant, can someone unmute the first person who's raised a hand and then uttered? Is it speak? Okay. We'll figure out how to respond to these questions. I think you are unmuted. And Gayatri Sundararajan. Can you speak? Okay. The topic, please don't raise your hands. It keeps being in my ears. I'm having a headphone on. So back to business operations. Facility. Where do you have your factory? Where do you start your factory? For which reasons? There is a separate topic in chapter 2 on this. Locate facility or the factory based on say availability of labor, any tax concessions, availability of raw material, needs to different transport options, ports, airports, and so road, so many things go into planning where you want to factory, and that's part of your with surface on topic in the second chapter. Plant and material handling. So design your plant. Where the production floor going to be, where the storerooms going to be, raw material storage, stores and spare storage, where are you going to have all this, where are going to be the admin building, where are going to be the restrooms, cafeteria, canteen, and where are you going to have the docks for unloading, loading, and so all these, even within the process, there be say within the core production process, there could be different components. He's heating raw material, somebody is shaping the raw material, that should have the heating parts, shape part, and so on and so forth. All these are part of your plant layout. Design. I would strongly recommend you all start spending time on you viewing manufacturing processes, product processes of large businesses. It could be car manufacturing or even anything. Say shoe manufacturing process. Clear video. How's the leather or the other raw material is prepared, shaped, cut, stiff, finished, and so on and so forth. Similarly, you can do look at any process. If you have History Channel, if you have not subscribed to it, if possible, subscribe to History, National Geographic, Discovery, or Geographic History, Discovery Channel, and Discovery Science. We are able to see a lot of these manufacturing process. So these days, they are also showing a lot of Indian manufacturing. So recently I saw the Anil's jeans manufacturing. You look at in general manufacturing process, food products, food tech, is there a there is a process. Made is in one of the channels. You can see all these business processes to understand how they are doing all this. Even then, they talk about why this product is designed in this way, so it can be made back. So you want to have margin, I'm talking about lakhs of units every month, every year. Then you design the product in a specific way so that you can manufacture it in large quantity. If the product is not designed well, you may not be able to manufacture it in large quantities. And then we'll touch on this more in detail in the third chapter. Process design. So how to design my process? It's going to be a continuous process or batch process. How I want to design my process, or is it going to be assembly, car manufacturing? They don't manufacture all the components in the factory itself. They just buy all the components, assemble it. And co-design, co-engine design is going to be there. Sometimes they even buy the engine. So once you ingredients, you assemble it and send it out under your brand. So how are you going to design your manufacturing process? And production quantity, how many units are you going to produce? When are you going to produce? And many places you would have seen this word control in business management. You plan, you start with a plan. Any business, any activity for that matter. Suppose go out, you start with a plan. How am I going to do it? Whether I'm going to take my two-wheeler, four-wheeler, auto, whatever it is. When will I be there at the destination and how long I'm going to spend there and so on and so forth. Similarly, you have planning. So how many units of each of the product I'm going to produce, when I'm going to produce, when is how long I'm going to store it, so on and so forth. So you plan that the actual some planning. So I want to score 75 in OMS. So I may end up scoring say 65 or 90. Plan was to score 75, but my actual was a bit different from the plan. So control exercise comes. Control exercise, why is there a difference between the plan and the actual? Difference. Say in suppose you clear the group, you don't look back, you don't try to understand why scored teams more in OMS. Some are thinking I will get only 75. Oh, God's grace, or thankfully I was here, I got 90, and you move on. But if it says I plan to produce 1 lakh units this month, I end up producing 110,000 units. I want to know why I produce 110. Then be able to see whether I can replicate this. Can I again do this next month? Can I improve production capacity of the plant? Which means my fixed cost per unit is going to come down. You earn costing, I believe, standard costing, absorption costing, first few chapters of your group one. What is happening? You are going to produce one, but you ended up producing 110,000 units. So your original fixed cost was say one lease. Each unit would have ₹1. Now if you want 10,000 units, each unit is going to end up only 0.9090. So your cost is going to come down, which means your profit per unit is going to go up because of using your improving your capacity. You want to know why that happened. If it goes down, again, you want to know why. That's bad because you planned to produce more, but you ended up producing less. Again, the same example, 1 lakh rupees, 1 lakh units was the plan, 1 rupee per unit fixed cost. You ended up using 90,000 units, which means 1.11 rupee per unit is going to be your fixed cost, which means you are losing that 11 paise every unit. A lot of money at the end of the year. So for a business operation which is doing a lot of units of the same product, so you know why that is happening. That's your control exercise. So planning and control. Then quality control. Control, you need the reality for the customers are going to be with you for a long time. Your reputation is built and retained. QR products for all errors. Again, more like a control, another control, right? Control checking plan versus actual. Plus, have the best quality. Zero maintenance for 5 years. You're selling a car, you say that no maintenance for 5 years. Or you're selling a mobile phone, say that 5 years guaranteed performance, no problem. Somebody comes back as soon as you sold it, in 2 weeks they come and tell that there is a problem with the display, problem with the sound, and so on and so forth. Then you're not delivering your quality. What will happen? You know, but in the future you will face struggle selling the same product because the reputation is going to spread very fast. And you have all the social media where they'll start criticizing the product and so on. So what you have to do? Quality control. So check for quality. As seen, stepping back a bit, I would want you to and whole subject from the point of view of some small business. You don't have to think about industries or Hindustan Unilever or PepsiCo. Think of mega industries, mega factories like this. You can think of some small business. A business you can think of the roadside shop, roadside food cart who's selling those idlis, dosas in the mornings and some mixed rice in the afternoon. That's a business. That's also a business operations. He is right. His facilitation, where is he going to keep his push cart? Then how is he going to arrange the goods on his push cart? Those are feet by 3 feet or 5 feet by 4 feet cart, it's a small area, but still he will arrange things in a way that becomes easy to access and reduces unwanted movement and so on and so forth. Again, there may not be too much of product design there, but even there could be innovation in presenting the dosa or idli. They may add some carrots on the top and then give you as a new product or a fresh look. That's it. So attracts customers. And the process design, how is he going to do it, what he is going to use, how many units per batch, depending on demand, how he wants to do it. So, action planning and control, he is planning to sell, say, 100 idlis today, is he able to sell 100, why he could not, was the challenge during the, say he anticipated to sell more, but sales was less, so he needs to know why that happened, because he's buying all these raw material and ingredients, making the sambar and chutneys, which are perishable. So store it for long. He doesn't have a fridge, refrigerator in his push cart. So he done it much diligently than a restaurant, because restaurants, they can deep freeze it. To want it, they can just take it out, reheat it, and give it to you. But not a push cart. They need to plan for everyday sales, raw material procurement, and so on. And the quality control, again, very important, whether the salt and then spice, everything is in the right mix in all these ingredients. He needs to know that. Otherwise, people will start avoiding shop. And to lose his customer, eventually shut down. So control is in that what you expected is delivered. So plan actual, the difference is quality, and that the difference is controlled. So they have to assess why these errors happened and eventually work towards improving the quality using different methodologies. This you see in chapter 5, I guess. So ISO, International Standard Organization, Six Sigma. There are various ways how you improve your quality improvement and so forth. It's going to be discussed in a separate subject, quality improvement, quality control. Management of your raw material, finished goods, how you're going to manage your economic order quantity, economic batch quantity, minimum level, maximum level, all that you studied in your costing, you'll also study in this subject. Maintenance management, your days and maintenance, how you do it. So when you give your machinery for service, again, your push cart, how clean, when you should be spending time to clean all the vessels, not in the peak hours, you need to plan it during off time, not disturbed by customers, or the customers are not disturbed when he's cleaning his vessels and there is somebody waiting in the queue. governance. Maintenance is upkeep. You clean things, oil it, and keep it running so that it can have a long life. Again, in cases, probably you have two wheelers, you give it for service. Service is maintenance, your maintenance activity. So you have to keep your vehicles running condition so that you can, you are not affected during any important travel. You're going to your office, suddenly there is no fuel, it stops, or there is some brake failure, you could not give the vehicle for service for a long time. All these must be planned out. So, look at it, production planning and control. Because early days, I'm talking 50 years back when Industrial Revolution happened, it was about production. As I can sell, because there are very few factories, a lot of demand, people are looking at these products for the first time, they all want to buy it. So all I need to do is ensure I'm producing. So very important. But today, it is not the case. So today, business management, earlier it was production management, just thinking of your raw material, making, delivering, nothing more than that. But today, it goes beyond production. All these things are also part of your business operations. You need to plan all these accordingly. Say, for example, factory location. How locations? Unless I start my factory in a good place where all these raw material and labor force are easily available, I struggle for my production. Correct? I need to bring all the goods from different places, spend a lot of time in travel. Cost, money goes out and bring all the inputs, and then attracting talent or people becomes difficult because I'm in a very remote area, there are no people nearby. These are also to be considered. That is again maintenance management. A lot of demand, you don't plan about maintenance on a morning at 10 o'clock when the entire factory is full. The maintenance manager is switching off the power, saying that I'm going to do maintenance now. That's absurd because it's going to affect your production. So these are part of your operations management. That is your decisions. Earlier, as I said, it was only concerned about production, but now talking about going production, these other areas. Now, objectives of operations management. Going slow or fast, you're all able to understand or not. So pause for a while. Can you some messages if you have any concerns with the way I'm doing it? So I'll quickly some of the messages. Able to follow. Thank you. So, objectives. I'm managing the operations. Why am I managing the business operations? There is supposed to be some reason why I'm able to, why I need to manage the business operations. So, why do you run any business? You're all answering. I'm not able to hear it. That's the advantage of this video session. Businesses are started for profit making, but profit cannot be the objective itself. It's the end result. Because you're managing some, you are getting profits. You don't manage it well, it'll be a loss. So what am I supposed to work on? I'm a hint here. You have material to handle, UL, various stores, all these are used. And you use different types of labor, skilled labor, unskilled labor, management, all these people come into play. These are input resources that are usable. Of course, so different resources are used. Sub restriction on material. So your marginal costing, stage of material, constructor, and so on. You may understand. Even other, suppose there is no limit on availability of material. Suppose free using that raw material. Suppose that is completely free, and it is limitless. There is no restriction availability. You be worried. Probably not. You may be worried looking at the environmental concerns, but in general you are not worried. Okay, use it as much as you want. But the case in business, if using some raw material, restriction on the availability of the raw material, and there is a cost to it. It is not endlessly available. Whenever I want, I cannot just keep getting it. Even water today is a scarce raw material. It's becoming more and more difficult to find good water to cook. Say suppose you go to all these small, again, push carts where they are selling idlis, dosas. They have these canned waters, right? Buy these canned waters. It's a resource now. It's freely available resource. You are paying to get good water today. Not coming off the tap as it used to be few back. All are paid, and there is limitation in availability. People, again, you cannot hiring more and more. India has no shortage of people, but the right talent to have plumbers, you need to have masons, you're constructing. You cannot just bring anybody from the road, go to the street, ask anybody who wants to join my construction business, just come in. You cannot do that. You need to have the right skill availability. So you're going to hire people with the right skill. Then you have to use them appropriately. And time, availability of time. When you commit to deliver, when are you supposed to make these purchases? All these are time-based. How long it takes to make a unit or makes to correct a mistake and so on and so forth. Any other resources. So when you are most main material and time, money is managed by finance department. Don't bring it here. Money is important, but it's managed by a different department. Take care of bringing working capital, so on and so forth. Capital working capital. So all these are concept resource utilization. So prime objective is using the resources appropriately, optimally. I would say optimal. Remember the word optimizing, optimal. That's going to study in the entire operations management. Any problem you solve, as looking at optimal assignment of work to different people. Transport, identify optimal number of units to be shipped from different warehouses to different markets. Optimal important. Resource utilization, you need to have the optimal resource utilization. So I always ask you to think from business terms. You don't have to go beyond the shop. Very clear about it. See, somebody who is making something. So think of these, say, flower vendors or fruit vendors. The one is they are not making anything. They are just buying and selling. Service industry. Whereas if you monitor or look at a small restaurant or a hotel, in our terms, restaurant is the right name. Street side fast food joints, when you look at them, you'll be able to understand how businesses are running faster, because observer lens industries and going what is happening, whereas you can do that in a street side food joint. So resource utilization, you have to utilize your resources optimally, so don't waste it. At the same time, don't underuse it. So you need some resource, you try to constrain input, what's the output will be affected. Need to use, again, I don't know how many of you are from Tamil Nadu, and I'm just giving the example of making these idlis. It has two ingredients, rice and dal. Urad Dal. If you say one is cheaper, one is costly. Again, you will study it in standard costing, material variance. One is a cheaper resource, another one is a costly resource. I to reduce the usage of that costly resource, what quality of the output is affected. So utilization is not about reducing the cost. It's about optimally using the ingredients. That is what you have to understand. So optimally using the ingredients towards the objective of the business. So one of the prime objectives, resource utilization. So there is that somebody who is requesting a piece and there's somebody else who's giving a piece and they match. So these are two puzzle pieces. There is a match, which means I was trying to say here is custom requirements. He's asked for a product. You give product, he's satisfied. He has a need. You add that need. Then that's important. Because you don't address that need, he's going to move on. He's not going to create a sale for you. He's just a prospect now. So the product of the quality. You're supposed to give the right quality product. It is not just giving the product. Give a product which breaks immediately, there is no point in selling product. So you give what right meet the requirement and of the quality and of the right price. What is optimal for that product? With these, the optimal product at the optimal quality at the optimal price, then we get customer satisfaction. So these are two ingredients. One is your resource utilization, the second one is your customer satisfaction. You have to add both these if you want to have very good running business. So resolution is managing your resources well, and customer satisfaction is meeting the needs of the customer in terms of product specificity, quality, and price. So you address all this. So there are your two core requirements. Now customer satisfaction, suppose the price goes up. Cannot be very happy charging too much for the product, but that comes with a higher quality, they'll be satisfied. Meets their needs is of course the basic criteria. You need to meet their needs. You give a needless product, they are not going to buy it. Again, the examples of all the different Android phones vis-a-vis Apple iPhones. So as smartphones, all the things as good as Android phone, pricing is very high because they commit to more data security, more quality of the product, and so on and so forth. More, but people are okay to buy. So okay to buy Apple iPhones. They make large say quantities and sell it, and they mean it. So they are customers, and more than the meeting the needs, it so is a status symbol. So people phone as a status symbol. Okay, have an iPhone, I carry an iPhone, I'm above you. I'm not in your league, I'm above you. That's the brand image of an iPhone. So people try to go for it. So various customer needs. You have to address all of those needs in terms of product specification, quality, price, then they are going to be happy. Product is very important. So these are the two main objectives. Focus on both the objectives. I cannot focus on only one. Suppose I keep focusing on resource utilization. I cut costs here and there. That's the same I talked about, right? I use the quality of the product because one of the ingredients is costly. Identity of that and increase the cheaper ingredient. So the quality of the product goes down. And when the product goes down, customer will be happy. Your reputation is going to be lost, your sales is going to be virtually lost, and you're unsustainable. Sustain is to be there for a very long time in the business. Where men may come, men may go, company on forever. You're a sustainable business. Sustainable is angles. One of the important angles is you should not focus only on resource utilization. Unsatisfied customers can lead to loss of reputation, loss of sales, and unsustainable. So again, example here, I give some very little sambar and I buy extra sambar. Then customers are going to say, yeah, the product is good, but they keep charging more and more for every sambar I ask because they give 4 idlis and a small cup of sambar. I'm not able to have it. Okay. So you are focused too much on resource utilization. Even if your quality is good, if you are too much focused on managing your resources, then the it will lose its reputation. I'm sure many of you have had experiences going to some restaurants where there's a strain in using the food, they stop you from or serve you less. So you're not very happy for a lot of price, they serve you less and you don't want to go there anymore. So that's one. And the other is, if you focus on customer satisfaction, you may end up wasting this. So asking for it, just give it. It's more to the customer. And you may end up in final loss because every ingredient has a cost. So you cannot keep giving free features. You keep getting more and more features without increasing the price and customer doesn't even care. So, but still you want to satisfy them. You want to give more and more to them. Again, the financial loss. Financially, this becomes unsustainable. Resources, unsustainable. You have to focus on both customer satisfaction as your resource utilization. Again, a similar example here. For 3 idlis, thinking that customer will be very happy. I give a lot of, so he's going to be very happy, he'll keep coming. Probably not. They're looking at this quantity of side dish for these 3 pieces of idli, and they may be switching their preferences. But still, you think that you are focusing only on customer satisfaction and you are wasting your resources. So make you financially unsustainable. So moving on, any questions so far? But I'll give you 3 minutes to type. Have any questions, please type here. Study material. I'm sure the end for all this, whatever I've taken it into my presentation. It's 2020 latest edition. I hope to see the institute study material here. Operations management, operating system, primary objectives, customer service or customer satisfaction. And the objective is your resource utilization. This year of and what wants manufacture goods at their record. That's what I've given there as a puzzle piece. So you have to give them the product at the price and time. Whenever they've asked for deliver it, they'll be happy. So you transport people one place to other the service. Right, they pick you from Chennai and drop you in New Delhi. That's a service. And you have to be keeping in the time it takes to do this. Suppose normal time is 15 hours. If there are delays, people will be irritated. So you need to make sure that you are delivering them or them from point A to point B within the given time. Again, I don't know if you keep traveling in all these fancy buses from Chennai or anywhere you are to different cities, APNs and RPNs and so on. About all these in the redbus.com. How do they give ratings once you are, say, they all do the same thing. They move people from one point to another. But people who are not satisfied with the cleanliness of the bus, that's very important. And then timeliness, keeping people being punctual, their bus with the pointed hour and reaching the destination at the given time, all these are very important. And the weights, delays, all these are going to irritate them. And supply of goods. This is manufacturing. The supply of goods and services. I have to deliver what the customer is asking. Again, delivery. I was talking about Dunzo, right? They are just giving, playing the goods. Bringing it. It's also a service. Goods is vegetable vendors who you see are all going to buy vegetables and sell it to you. They are just supplying it. You have to end. Timing is very important. When you are delivering this is key. So the street vegetable vendor who comes to your street every day, suppose one day you're going to be upset with him because every day you buy vegetables at a vendor at say 10 in the morning, do your cooking and get it ready 12 in the noon for lunch. And if you be delayed, your cooking process is going to be delayed and you'll be upset. And if he's delayed regularly, then you may want to switch the option. So that's supply, and you have to ensure that the right quality of goods are supplied at the right price. And time is also very important. Service you are providing, whether it's delivery service or any other service, it needs to be, again, right quality, the right time. There is no delays. Transport is a service, right? Again, no delays, no waiting time, and quality of it is so forth. Quality can't be product quality. The person who is doing the service is maintaining himself is also very important. That's why these uniforms for these Swiggies and Zomatos and all this, they don't want people to be anything of their choice and then going and standing in front of a customer and they are very upset with the person or the way they are dressed and so on and so forth. So that's very important. So again, another example for quality is not about just your product quality. The way you maintain your restaurant and the way you clean and keep your vessels say spotless are also very important, because that also affects the or the satisfaction of the customer. Suppose the plate not clean or the things are not clean, people may stop coming to your place. So that's also very important. And utilization, which we talked about, then resource utilization and scope. I've just clicked this and pasted it there, or not pasted it, recreated it in the PowerPoint. So this production and operations management as part of this we saw. Now manufacturing and recent trends. So as I've shared the entire notes for the subject earlier to various batches. I can to the institute and they can email it to you all. For all the theory topics and it has a compilation of for all the problems. So read it from the book to understand once, and then go to the handout, and then for examination purposes, it's all place. I have concised the answers and made it easy for you to understand and reproduce in the exams. A testimonial from one of the students that he studied only those notes and he was able to get 60 marks, 56 or 58. Miss OM theory. He did not even touch the book, but I'm recommending that. Again, will be available. It's already with me. I can send it to the institute later today, and they'll be emailing it to you at the appropriate time. Yes, theory in the exam. I think you generate. There are going to be about 60 marks, 50 to 60 marks worth theory. About equal number, 40 to 50 marks worth problems. So it's very important. Theories, again, 30 marks is straightforward theory because it's strategic management, and even operations management, there will be 20 marks worth theory. That's why I have I think it's 50 pages or so, about 40 to 50 pages worth theory is there for all these 70 marks. So read able to manage the theories comfortably. Read the study material, and for your reference, use that notes and prompts. Solve all the problems from the study material. Again, the problems are from the material in the exams. So you run into all these other additional reading material, additional books, unless you have a lot of time. See, there's no harm in solving more problems from various sources. But if you are doing good all the problems in the book, that is more than enough. So I'm not stop learning from other sources, but minimal requirement is from the study material. Okay, to open man's a competitive advantage. Operations. Again, go back in time, 1800s, 1900s, manufacturing was all done for demand. There's a lot of demand, there are very few suppliers, they keep producing more and more and selling more and more. Not bothered about anything else. But today, manufacturing process must be really efficient for you to withstand competition. Could itself be a competitive advantage to you? Say process. Something. Say for example, if you go to, they were making laddus with hands. Now there is a machine to make those laddus. They have automated the process. Whatever demand they are able to meet it. So people expect to have those laddus when they go to Tirumala. So it becomes easy for them to match the demand, maintain the deliverables. And if you want, again, this is a different scenario altogether. They need to come. But if it's a business, suppose all these say snacks you are having, many of these snacks making is automated, right? Think of chips. So automated the whole process. Interestingly, when they came to India, this size potatoes to make those Lay's chips in those specific size and shape. So seeds or some US give it to the farmers in Punjab, made them plant it, harvest it, and give it to them exclusively the right size and shape, and then they started using it for manufacturing Lay's chips in India. So they have to make million packs every day and flooding the entire market with their packets. So packed, air-packed, airtight container packs you are seeing in all these shops, they are manufacturing processes. The small competitors are not able to meet their pressure or meet their standards. They promise quality, they promise. These are 10 rupees, 15 rupees. Though it's mostly 90% air inside the pack, but they are able to give it to you at a very low cost. People are able to buy it. Go to a chip store who fry chips in front of you and sell it. They have more quality or more to eat. Apparently, they will not be able to give it to you at that price and at that timing and has the ability whenever you want. All these are difficult. That's why manufacturing has become a competitive advantage today, unlike earlier days. So if my process is super fine and I'm able to deliver the right product at the time at the right place without any gap. So that somebody is not having such a manufacturing process, they are out of the game. They are to say withstand this pressure from these organized manufacturing. And even within the industries I'm talking about, I'm not talking about the street vendors and all that. Even within the say large organizations, if somebody running it very competitively, then are take market. Example is all car manufacturing. It was back Daewoo Motors. I don't know if you know Daewoo Motors. It was there about 20 years back. There were Daewoo cars on the street, but they couldn't meet the condition from the large vendors or service providers, say Jio, Airtel. They are strategic competitive strategies, strong strategies, and small players are I'm calling small players, unprepared people are just getting out of the market. Vodafone is struggling. Because it's government funded, it's still running. Otherwise, they'll also be struggling. All these are your business a competitive advantage. So that's the modern operations. One aspect. Presentation. Again, long about once you sell, that's it. You don't have to worry about anything. Upkeep it, maintain it, use it, all those are the customer's headache. And if it's working, they are supposed to go and buy another one or figure out how to fix it. All these are the customer's headache. But today, it is so. Air conditioner. Tell you that, sir, we can give you 2 years free service. But see, my purpose is to buy an air conditioner. Maintain it in working condition is my headache. Why would they take that responsibility? They say the two free service, sir, will our cars. They say car and also give you free service maintenance. First, the experience is also very important. It's not thing is not the very event. Thing say usage, which is going to create experiences. And on the experience, the customer is going to become a loyal customer, give feedback, improve your good, bring in more customers. It's the buying. Okay, very happy buying as AC. So also buy it. No recommendation like that. I bought old as AC 2 years back. It is super fine and people are there to service it practically without even me calling. They are following up, coming and using it. And quality of the chillness is very good. So you also buy it. That people give recommendation, right? So it's beyond services that's offered along with the product. Or even in a restaurant, even if the food is not that great, you may give a recommendation based on the quality of service. Say they are very polite, pleasant, neatly dressed, and they're at your service all the time. They're asking for more side dishes, offering water without even us asking. So all the experiences, service orientation of these businesses, which are giving this advantage. Again, these were not there long time back. Today, because of the mountain competition among all these suppliers, they are having to different. So that's modern operations. This is stacks, just so you what is smokestack. This stack. So smokes are from factory. So manufacturing is becoming more and more electrically driven. Processes managed by electronic machines, computer managed, robotics managed. So there is little of these smoke coming out. So you be environmentally friendly, and that is also one of the reasons why you make a recommendation. And polluting the environment, so people are happy with your business operations. They want to be loyal to you. You say that I am and eco-friendly. These products are eco-friendly. We don't use chemicals, or we pollute the environment, or the resources we take from the nature. So if you read a Pepsi say sticker, when you go back, they claim that we need more water than we take from the earth. I don't know how that, but they still claim it. So all these are very important. People are start cut those environmental concerns issues as well. So Dove smokestacks. Today it's all electric, electronic, modern. And it's become beautiful.
Nash needs that small delta. Again, again, the restaurants, I keep talking about simpler examples, what you have experienced. Multi-restaurant. You may find it in small towns even today, not in the cities, not much in the big cities these days. We go to a restaurant, they'll claim Chinese, Mexican, not Mexican normally, Chinese, North Indian, South Indian, everything. You can buy from there. So the product manufacturing was set up earlier. Business for delivering anything and everything. Today, we've gone becoming very niche players. Niche, very specific focus area. They provide quality and experience. Mexican restaurants. You go there, you get very good quesadillas or burritos. Some may say that we also sell these. We also sell that. You may not get that experience. When you go to Mexican, those specialty-based foods. Or in restaurant, you go and then you have some good pizza or pasta. And then go to a run-of-the-mill, these Domino's and Pizza Hut. You may not be able to get the same quality that comes from these small boutique businesses. So boutiques, small is nothing but niche or boutique businesses who are focusing only on a specialized skill. Like doctors, right? Earlier, there used to be hospitals. For anything and everything, you go to a hospital, somebody will giving you a treatment for something. But today, there is a orthopedic specialty, there is a neurology, there is a cardiology. Everything has a separate hospital. There are specialists building hospitals only on these specialties. So a focused business where you can focus more on improving the quality of service, improving the diversity of the products you are delivering within that small specialty, more business approaches. So think of any small means focus area, need not be a very small 100 square feet shop. It is talk about the area of focus is very small. They are not just doing in everything. And could be say the Samsungs, they produce everything, right? In television, air conditioners, any phones, they produce a lot of these electronic goods. And still, in terms of valuation, Apple is far ahead of them because just focusing on few areas. At least now they have diversified into very various products. When Steve Jobs was doing this, he was focusing mainly on the handheld phones and other devices. Mac and iPhones were the main areas of focus. Mac, iPhone, iPods. So why were they focusing only those? Because only then their innovation in that area. They can research a lot more in that area, spend a lot of money, invest a lot of money in that particular product and be the best. Similarly, all these practicing accountants, chartered accountants, cost accountants are at a generic board. But now there are some tax specialists, there are appeals specialists, and the GST specialists, corporate specialists, specialists. So they are generic shops. You need service, come to me, I'll give you the best service, but I charge the right price for that. You cannot expect ₹100 per tax return because I'm a specialized personal tax consultant. I know to give it possible results, use all the do the right interpretation of all the tax laws and then give you the best recommendations. I charge for that because I know in and out of all these laws. That's the focus. So recent trends. That's the last one in the first chapter. And we are left with 40 minutes. Trends. What is in the market business? Marketplace. Early something you sell in your city, in your state, probably at best in your country. Lot of digitalization, globalization, and enhancement of transport facilities, all the made possible these products across the globe, or across the globe and deliver it from one point. Suppose you want to sell it on Amazon.com, you can sell it and deliver it from here. All these ads, right? I don't know whether you follow the ads. There are some craftsmen in Rajasthan or Odisha, where they are making all these, say, their local products, especially local products, designs, and arts, artifacts, and they are able to sell it across the globe today. They have their own website, or they can sell it through various channels. So, global marketplace. To say, keep the mind when you're running a business. Lays is a US company. Chips vendor in India would have thought about Lays being a competitor 20 years back. Today, they are a competitor. Or Coke and Pepsi, and all these drinks, which clean out the market here. And then for your business operations, you need to have a right strategy with reference to what you want to become, what product you want to focus on, what is the market share you want to take on to get it done, how are you going to expand, all those operation strategy. So you have to have strategic approach to the whole thing. Total management. Tomorrow, total quality management. You are supposed to focus on quality, not just in terms of the product, but also where it's made, who's delivering it, and all the other things around it. I keep giving the examples of all these, say, movie halls. The movie halls never used to be super clean. Screens, Chennai, many of you are from Chennai, you'll know that Devi Paradise had the screen ever earlier. But SaaS came in, and then they redesigned the whole experience. So they started clear places, restrooms are super clean, your food stalls are super clean, people are all in uniform, neat shape, neat dressed. So people are moving towards these screens because it's just the quality. Sometimes it's not even about the quality of the product. It's about these other things which you get. Again, example of restaurant, don't be frustrated. Each side food court or food stalls give you better tasting idlis and sambars and chutneys than when you go five star hotel, the cafe in ITC or the Southern Spice in Taj Hotel, Nungambakkal. You go, you don't get that taste. These small places, so the Sangeeta will give you a better quality. Why go to a street side restaurant for comparison? Sangeeta has a decent and gives quality or the right better quality tastes better than in these places. But where you eat is also important. People consider that to be very important. So ITC has that grandeur, or this Taj has it grandeur. So when you're taking some special, you don't want to take them to a Sangeeta. You are more bothered about the quality of the ambience, the restrooms, the service staff, how they do when you go in, and so on and so forth. So management goes beyond just the product quality. Flexibility. Your ability to operate based on demand. So that's also very important. Flexibility of your business and or product, the features you bring in. Tried something out sometime back. Maker in all the phones. I give a pixel camera in all the phones. They're selling these as components. Whatever component you can take and plug a motor phone and get that feature. So the phone is the basic phone which everyone will get. And then the flexibility is, if you want good sound, you are a movie buff, you watch a lot of movies, you can buy that speaker. Or if you are, say, using it for gaming, you can have a gaming add-on and so forth. So they started selling these components, made the product more flexible. So people are trying to buy everything that's sold as part of the phone, which many of those features you don't need. You're going for a product that's flexible. Even the manufacturing process being flexible, to increase or decrease my output depending on the demand. Without my utilization. Suppose I am a very labor heavy company, I'll not be able to do that easily. But if I'm mechanized, I'm running electronic processes, robotics, then be able to be more flexible with the quantity or product which I'm releasing depending on the demand side. So that's also the recent trend. All these were not present few decades back. They do have time study, motion study, and try to reduce the time it takes to deliver. So if these pizzas, they say it can be cooked and 30 minutes at your doorstep. You can say you call and give an order, less than 30 minutes at your doorstep. There's a lot of planning and delivery, and then risks around delivering it to your place, all taken care. So they maintain that time. And why? Because he's saying 40 minutes. I'll do it in 40 minutes. And when I think of ordering, normally when I'm hungry, I think of ordering something. Half time is okay. The other shop says 40 minutes. Okay, let's go for half an hour. So product making, if there are competitive products, one is made very fast, they can make more quantities and flood the market with their product. So the other competitor will lose out. So time action, scientific time measurements are done. Motion study is part of your syllabus, but scientifically this is all done and people are that in the regressions. Technology, needless to say, you discovery science, discovery channel, history, and look at all these processes, or go to YouTube, look for it at business processes, they'll show you a lot of things. Think all you have to do is stay and monitor, ensure that business is running or the machinery is running. So having a problem, you just intervene only to that repair exception. Other than that, it is an automated product process and delivery is seamless. You don't have to worry about it at all. So emergence technology. Work environment. Again, if you want old movies, Indian movies, add this labor strike, not pay the bonus, were upset, they did not produce. So there was always this disconnect between the management and the workers. They used to show this a lot in all these movies. But today, not so. People to give more ideas, involve in the product design, process design, because they are doing the job day in, day out. They know what change will make the process much more efficient. So, or the people selling the product in the front line, the employees who are selling your goods in the front line knows better feedback than your board who are sitting in a room trying to decide what changes to make. So your sales rep, there you go. Sir, I tried to sell this, but people are asking for some of these additional features. Or change these features. They are not happy with this. All this comes from whom? The person who's interacting with the customer, who's the sales employee. So sales and service staff. Similar stuff can give you ideas on production, product design improvement, process design improvement. So people are all involved these days and they are given rewards, recognition. R&R is a common term these days in all these businesses, rewards and recognition. So you have to reward the employee, recognize him for his efforts, his achievements. Only then he'll continue to be, otherwise he'll move on. So that's which was there some years back. Re-engineering. I was talking about re-engineering some time back too, right? Some did the whole thing. Re-engineered the experience. Doing something for better. So this business was done so far. We have re-engineered the whole thing. Now the experience is different. Food delivery. France. So you have to make a call. You know that you have to go sit in a restaurant and eat. Then you have to call that specific restaurant, place an order, they'll add a delivery charge and deliver at your doorstep. Swiggy's and Zomato's and all these people have changed the way it is done, right? So that's re-engineering the whole process, rethink the whole business model. So that's re-engineering. Engineering it to is make something, re-engineer it to re-create the whole thing differently. Again, there is a top engineering towards the end of your book, chapter 10. Environment, we talked it. People are more concerned about not the product, but also how it's made. If products are made by... If people are worried about how it's made, there are a lot of campaign against wearing leather, right? So why kill animals to wear your fancy handbags and shoes? Go for leather. Can somebody who's speaking go on mute? Shoes are somebody who's polluting a lot. So though it produces a lot of power, make state power positive, is it power positive? But people don't want it because it's an environmental concern. So, people are looking at all these as well. They are not just looking at the product alone, the output alone, even if it's of very good quality. If the background is, say, of the company is not good, they try to move away from that company. They don't want to associate themselves with that brand. They want to move away from that brand. So, quite sizing. This keeps happening. People are trying to make use of more technology and keep management at the right size. If people use consultants, don't try to hire full-time. There are, say, today there are part-time CFOs. CFOs were supposed to be important roles in companies, but today people are looking for part-time CFOs. So you are a CFO for four or five different companies. You are a consultant, you go and work as CFO in two, three different companies, four companies, because you have the expertise and you are able to give them the right advice at the right time. But you don't have a full-time job, because accounting can be taken care by anybody. Finance, advice, funding, overall management of finance, all these can be done by somebody who don't have to be sitting there full time. So that's your corporate sizing, right sizing, one of the approaches. Or you have a lot of unwanted processes, cut down those and then reducing. That's why they have used the word right sizing. Downsizing doesn't mean that I compromise on processes, practices, and then cut down on stuff. I still have all these processes, but have better technology to manage it, or say de the process so that I can manage it with lesser skilled resources. See, again, CMAs or CA who are practicing this find of competition from these practicing tax consultants who are general graduates who know this tax filing website, online filing, and all that. They come as a competition. So reskill yourself. Come say, real professional and stand in front of your customer and say that this is the differentiator. Why I'm better than a generic, say, tax consultant is I bring all these qualities. I bring understanding. I help you beyond just return filing. Tomorrow is an assessment that tax file cannot help you. I'll be able to help you. And so forth. So all the necessary processes, retaining it and then de-skilling it, substituting with lower skill resources, and then removing all the unwanted processes is very important. A document needs to go through 20 different signatures. But a company, private company, it will probably go through one or two signatures. There are two people, three people who are looking at it and signing it off, and the project is on. So, sizing the staffing. Supply chain management. Supply is giving the material from the factory, delivering the material from the factory to the customer is the supply part. It is not a single process, it's a chain process. It starts somewhere, moves to different distribution hubs, from there to different retail hubs, from there to different retail stores, from there to the customers. Or if you have spare warehouses, you move from different factories to different warehouses, from there to different distributors, from there to your customers. However, it. So this is very important. Today, being a global marketplace and a lot of competition, you would observe, right, that Apple, when they are releasing their new model, it's released at the same time across the globe. How is this? You need to be very, say, scientific about how you manage your supply chain. Similarly, if you are a Harry Potter buff, you would have noted that all Harry Potter books, especially the later ones, were released at the same time across the globe because people worry about reading it at the same time, the first ones to read it. So queue up in front of these bookstores a day before, wait the night, and buy this book. supply chain is very important, because all these are not going to be published in different locations across the globe. It's going to be centrally published, printed, and distributed from that location to across the globe. At times, so it's available in all the stores, all the important stores, all the key retailers at the same time. So that's supply management. That's very important. And if you upset people, they are not going to be to your brand. See, loyalty is very tough. All these processes are part of that. Once you lose your brand loyalty, people will switch and you lose your business. Processes. Simple downsizing or right sizing. Lean. Going lean is unwanted processes, unwanted material from the product, so that it's not thin. The product itself is lean. It has very less wastage or no wastage. So you try to make the process more efficient, reduce wastage. Why am I doing it? One, I can improve my profits by reducing the usage of material. Plus, I also can pass on the benefit to the customers and be very competitive with my price, because my process is very lean. I don't waste raw material. I don't waste any of the scrap. I try to sell it, or I try to reduce the scrap generated and make the product very efficiently. There's a lean production process. That when the production, as I said, you can keep the customer happy by reducing his price as well. So the impression that we are environmentally responsible, we are not wasting valuable resources. Suppose you have a lean production process in a paper making company. You can, we are lean in using the forest resources, so it makes us very environmentally friendly and behind the classmate notebooks. Many of you may have it, you can see they tell that they use a lot of recycled material in making these books. So that's important process. So all our part of your chapter one, the introduction to operations management. I gave you a minute or two in the beginning to say about what is operations management. Now, at the end of the introductions chapter, so plan, schedule, and control. So, your original assumption, what we studied, and try to make adjustments. So brains learn better from mistakes than from plain reading. So once you are able to compare and contrast what you thought about this and what is it actually, they're able to retain the learning for a longer time. So this is all the first chapter, a few pages in your book. I open the floor for some questions. We have about 20 minutes. So somebody had my class in the past, and you are in probably one of the groups, may OMSM groups or group two groups, say in the WhatsApp, where a lot of knowledge sharing happens. If so, you may know my number already. So please, you can write to Stu to ask for the material. I'll release the material later this evening to them. Mail it and they can share it with you. And questions on those material. As and when we complete a topic, if you ask questions, it will be better. Can you? To ask these questions in the topics. And I'm studying, attending any web sessions and so on and so forth. I don't know where any group members are here. Let me check. stop my screen for a while. Link to one of the groups. I've paste link. You can join. Some number of members in a group, any restriction, I don't know. If time restriction, then we have to the group. Okay, 257 students already. Oh, props group is full. Wait, class, or no. And I'll just group. I've included Prashant. Good, please. Okay. So any. So far on this topic, any questions here? You have management, probably four will be started by Rishari professor. In the same timings, 1:30 till 3:30. And chapter. Who's that in the background? I don't know. Okay. Okay. Which will you cover? Planning to cover this chapter 1, 2, 3 and then 7, 4, 5, 6. We have planned to 4, 5, 6 plan to be covered by Chari sir. And then strategic management, I'm planning to do chapter 8 and 10. 9 is going to be covered by Mr. Chari sir. And the addition to these lectures, I've recorded and put some of the videos over the few months in YouTube on the so YouTube. My name is Srivatsan's PB. Then to find the there, especially problem topics. I've not covered theory topics like this. So you try to. Refer those well, and then to write the answers in the exams. Give me some time, not in this first session, to do a session here or try to load something to YouTube. So. In essence, what do we have to start another chapter now? Given the last few minutes we have got. So in search YouTube with my science space PB, there are let's mostly problem topic videos on. I think 4, chapter 7, chapter 2, there's problem topic areas where I've put some videos. To put some more over the next few weeks. Introduction, second chapter is about forecasting and then logics utilization, about all covered in the, and the or material management. All in the second chapter. Then the you go third chapter is about product and process design. Here I'll use the material. So this is all the production planning and control related topics, your transportation, assignment, queuing theory, simulation, and linear programming, all these things come in the fourth chapter. I own fifth chapter, which is about productivity management and quality management. We got ISO, and then say TQM and all that. Is your PERT, CPM, etc. Before I proceed, financial calculators are not allowed. You have to use regular calculators. Write your own words as long as it's grammatically correct, not too off the topic, you can sure use your own words. All day you'll have classes. Monday, Tuesday, it's going to be OMSM. Rest of the days, you will get your schedule. Emails will come from the institute on what topics are going to be covered in the other classes, other days. And then, where you're going to do what? Going, the next chapter is about project management, your CPM, Gantt, and all that. And then, one chapter is about maintenance management. We talked briefly about maintenance, servicing your bike, or clean and oiling your machinery, work running. So, that's our eighth chapter on work management. First, is the introduction, what is, etc., and what is the how to select a strategy, and so on and so forth. And then the strategic planning analysis concept, like your SWOT and BCG matrix, all those are going to be in chapter 9, the specific standalone topics. And then to 10, interactive strategy, native strategies, processing strategies, and so on and so forth. And the process reengineering related. Said, for those who did not join in the beginning, 30 marks SM fully theory, 20 marks operations management, partially theory, at least 15 to 20 marks, if not more, is going to be problems. Normally, are very simple, and handout you will see that there's a compilation of problems. All you have to do is comfortable with the problems in the book. As in transportation are important operation research topics. However, in point terms of exam, you don't have to get worked up if you're not able to understand these topics. Don't worry. Good choice. Plus, they're not going to ask you the entire problems from end. So, you can. Only the allocation or optimization or parts, bits and pieces of the problems. Again, go back to the chat. There are some chat messages popping up. For pen, shall use a type of pen, like stick pen. Like to me, I'll write it. And allotment. As you say, 70-30, and beyond that, a lot of them given in the book. From wise, see, you don't have to worry about mark allotment. And see, because it's 250 pages, many of these are problem topics, varied topics. All the theory is covered in less than 50 pages in my handout. So just be comfortable. Don't worry about whether that will be sufficient. As I said, 90 marks, one of my students has scored. And this was more than enough. And shout out in the WhatsApp group. Anything? The whole SARCMA. Prashant, are you there? I just call. I wanted to ask whether you have any instructions to be passed on for to, are there instructions for the next session or anything you want to communicate? Okay, perfect. Communicate that and then close the session. Thank you. The good thing, all the recorded videos of all these sessions would be on SARC, CI, whatever you are getting it, probably you'll get a communication on your emails as to where to access these videos. So these are added and it will be on a weekly basis. basis. Now immediately next week you will be able to access these videos in your SARC portal. So concerns or are done here. So so we have closed the meetings. Thank you everyone. If you have any questions, just share the link. You can also share the link with anybody else who did not join, and we can have conversations on the group. If you have doubts, please ask me. I can respond to that. Bye bye.
Okay.
Thanks for having this. Bye bye.